could tell that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because it couldn't jam. The captain seemed to understand. Because the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Can you tell us about the aircraft museum?
This aviation museum has been around for about 15 years now, and it's mainly to show people the history of some of the aircraft from World War II,
yeah.
Gone through to Vietnam and so on. And we've got the jets, which has gone up to about the 70s.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's mainly to show the people the history of Australian the Australian Air Force.
The uniquely Australian aircraft in this museum?
Yes, they are. Some of them, like the Mirage, is built has been built in France, but it's also been built in Australia under contract from the French. The P-38 Lightning that we have here, that's been actually renovated here in Australia, and the Mirage as well has been put together here as well after I had a mishap in. At Tullamarine, so
it's just a group of volunteers that look after the aircraft here.
Yeah, the volunteers here. We clean the aircraft and so on, and maintain it. And we're also responsible for building at the other section at our workshop.
Do maintenance, and you can sort of remake parts and stuff.
Yeah,
as well?
We're building another plane over there. That's going to be part of the collection for the museum. So,
So here's a spooky one. You know how there's haunted hangars and stuff that, and people always like to think about that. What do you reckon about some of these aircraft having a lost airman or something like that? Anything spooky happened in this hangar?
I don't know about any of that. I haven't felt any of that presence, but some people do are scared to go inside the Mirage.
Ah.
They get inside and they say the whole thing is freaky because they can actually see themselves flying at high speed and so on, and they feel a presence in the Mirage itself. And and some people will say the same thing about the Sea Venom. We have a Sea Venom here. That when they sit inside, they would say that they feel a presence inside of it. Yeah. So
I think any equipment or object that's been through a world war has got to have something left over, don't you?
Yes, I'm pretty sure of that, yeah.
Again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do. Till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know where.